However, while most of us are taught that tornadoes sound like a freight train, this one hardly made a sound. Storm chaser Wesley Luganville recalls that day.
June 23rd, it was a very unique circumstance in what you call in meteorology a conditional setup. The conditions are there, but they don't think storms will fire. You get moisture moving up onto that terrain in Colorado, and especially that much moisture. It's normally not a 70-degree dew point. It was well above that, so it was one of those days I was sure that something was going to happen regardless.
He also witnessed the storm dwindle down, build again, dwindle down, and build again, finally raging into an F3. What took Johnny and Myrna over 40 years to build would be gone in a matter of minutes. Observation program leader Michael Nosco of the National Weather Service recalls going to work that day.
The storm in particular that hit the DuValls, it developed fairly rapidly from what I recall, and we started seeing really good rotation on the radar.
Myrna and Farah were there on the farm place and had just come back inside from doing the evening chores. Something that John and Myrna had done over two decades ago would contribute to saving their life this day. All those years ago, the DuValls put their landline phone number down on a National Weather Service call list, something that the National Weather Service encourages those who live in very remote and very rural areas to do.
With the way it works with our computer system, their name and address, if they had a landline and they had a number in the phone book, we put it in our phone system with their address. All these names just plotted as a dot on our map. One issue we've seen over the years, a lot of these rural places are going to cell phones, so thank God that the DuValls had their landline still, because if they didn't, I would have never got a hold of them.
Myrna hardly ever answers the landline phone anymore, but she remembers hearing it ring and thinking she should answer it.
Whenever I called them, when Mrs. DuVall answered the phone, I don't know, I had this urge come over me that they need to get to shelter now. So I'm not sure if it took quite a turn towards their house, but it looked like the circulation, the center of it, was heading right towards their location. And she told me her daughter was in the shower, and I was like, you have to get her out of the shower. You got to get to shelter immediately.
At the same time, Johnny is out fixing fence southeast of their farm. Because the tornado is hidden behind a curtain of hazy rain and humidity, Johnny has no idea that it's on the ground and headed for his house until it's virtually on their back doorstep. He looks up, and in that moment, he sees the tornado barreling towards his house. Because the cell service out there is so terrible, he can't even call Myrna to warn her of what is heading for their home, and he doesn't know that Mike just called her. So what does a true cowboy do? He gets in his pickup and he races home, driving straight towards that tornado. Meanwhile, storm chaser Wesley Luganville unknowingly captures the tornado taking out the DuVall home place. Wesley was over 3.5 miles away and couldn't tell with the naked eye. It was only until the next day that he discovered what his dash camera had captured. While reviewing the footage over and over again, Wesley noticed a small dot racing across the bottom of the screen. He figured out it was Johnny in his pickup racing to get Farah and Myrna to safety. You can see Johnny here in this clip. Johnny arrived moments before the tornado hit the house. As he walked in the door, he called for Myrna and Farah to let them know to hit the deck. They were on their way to the basement. Farah still had shampoo in her hair. Here is video footage of the tornado as it hovered and churned over the DuVall farm and ranch for over 2.5 minutes. Thank you. If one thing had gone differently that day, if Mike hadn't called Myrna, if Johnny hadn't looked up and gotten out of the future path of the tornado, we might not have the Duvalls here with us today.
What's interesting is after the fact, after the storm went through, once it got away and I wasn't worried about the lightning or anything like that anymore, I tried calling them back and I just rang. I could never get through to them.
The Duvalls survived an F3 with sustained winds of over 155 miles per hour, shaking the subfloor of their home where they sought shelter. This is the pickup Johnny drove in on.
Of a family home that has seen decades of memories now gone.
And told me that they had a sun radar and there was a tornado on the ground headed towards us, so to take shelter.
There was no time to put on shoes, grab the 12 dogs, or move the cattle. Taking shelter in the cellar, the Duvalls tell me they stayed there for what felt like 5 minutes.
It was long enough you'd begin to think, because the house would shake a little, you know, and as she said, I hope the subfloor of the house doesn't come down.
Coming out of the cellar, Myrna said there was nothing left.
There was nothing.
Very fine, we didn't get hurt. Oh, you hurt your spirit a little, but hell, we can build back.
When the tornado hit Holly, Colorado in 2007, the Duvalls were some of the very first to show up on the scene with heavy equipment loaded full of diesel, ready to get to work, helping recover. The community poured out their love and support for the Duvalls the very next day after they were hit. But that is what defines our strength as Americans, and especially as members of the agriculture community. Just like the Duvalls showed up to the Holly tornado for help without being asked, so many people showed up to their farm place to help them without being asked. Johnny and I visit and we look onto this pile of rubble, which used to be his farm and ranch. A neighbor found this pile of what looks like shredded paper about a mile or so away from the place. It's one of his livestock barns. KKTV news reporter Caitlin Quisenberry broke the story of what happened to the Duvalls.
I've never seen a tornado devastation before in my life, so this was very shocking. You see, like, houses along this road are fine, and then you see John and Myrna's, and it's devastated. It was crazy to see that it hit just their house. That was the amazing thing, though, and all of that, there's people just lined up along this, parked along their driveway right there, and it's hard to find parking because there are so many people. And that was just amazing to see as I'm walking out, trying to go find John and Myrna.
Caitlin was the first reporter on the scene, and she noticed how much Johnny and Myrna made sure she was okay, in spite of losing everything they had. The first thing to go back up on the Duvall home place was the American flag, a symbol of perseverance, resiliency, and grit. Johnny wasted no time setting the flagpole and raising Old Glory once again. There are still many challenges ahead of the Duvalls in rebuilding, especially in this time in our country. But here are some of the things that are in front and center of the Duvalls' minds. Educating the public that this tornado was a freak of nature and it didn't act like other tornadoes in our area's history. It moved in the completely opposite direction as what we're used to out here. It didn't sound like a freight train. Johnny and Myrna both were surprised at how they never heard the freight train sound. And one other thing that is top of mind throughout this process is that if you do live in the country, isolated away from towns, do call the National Weather Service and sign up for the alerts. Certain TV stations' news apps have a weather feature that will alert you if there is a tornado in your area. Turn on your notifications on your cell phones. Keep an eye on the skies when bad weather is possible, and don't ever underestimate a tornado. On behalf of all the volunteers who have pulled together to create this event and make it a reality, I'd like to officially welcome you all to the DuVall Benefit Concert. Thank you to each and every one of you who has come here tonight, given your time, your money, your donations. The live auction is getting underway, and we appreciate everyone here in Southeast Colorado for all your support. God bless.